The SPC for Excel software program contains two data transformation techniques. One's the Box-Cox transformation, the other is the Johnson transformation. We're going to focus on the Box-Cox transformation in this video, but in either case, what you're trying to do is make your data normal. Perhaps you have some skewed data, but you have a statistical technique that requires a normal distribution. In that case, you want to try and transform your data into a normal distribution using, in this case, the Box-Cox transformation. So how do you do that? What you do is you transform the data using this equation, y to some value of lambda, power of lambda. And lambda can range from minus 5 to 5. And what you want to do is you want to find a lambda that minimizes the standard deviation. And for example, if you do this and you discover lambda equals 2, that means your transformed data then is the square of x. Or if lambda equals 0.5, it's the square root of x. Lambda equals 0 is a special case. It's then the ln of x. All the way down, if it's lambda is minus 1, it'd be 1 over x. But let's take a look at how the program does the Box-Cox transformation. To run the Box-Cox transformation using the SPC for Excel software, you begin by entering data into an Excel spreadsheet, as we've done here. We have 100 data points in the first column. It can be in multiple columns, it can be in rows, but just for this example, we have it in column A. And so you select your data, and then you go to the SPC for Excel ribbon and select Data Transformation. And we're going to run, of course, the Box-Cox transformation, so we'll select that. This is the range containing the data. It's found automatically based on the selection you have in the worksheet. If that first cell contains a word, that's assumed to be the name of your data, and it is in columns. And then you're ready to generate the results, and you simply say OK. And the program generates the results. Now let's take a look and see what those results mean. This is the first chart that's shown for the Box-Cox plot, and what it is, it's a plot of sigma versus the values of lambda. Remember, what we're trying to do is we're trying to minimize the standard deviation by finding that different values of lambda. And in this case, it'll tell you where the sigma was estimated from. We estimated from the moving range, since it was data in a column, it assumed we were dealing with an individual chart, and it plots the values of sigma for the various values of lambda, and you can see that a minimum occurs down in here around 0.3. But of course, since there's variation in the process, that's not an exact number, so there's going to be a range of lambda values to consider, and we use a 95% confidence limit to define that range, and that's these red lines here. That means the value of lambda can really occur anywhere within here. And up in the upper right-hand corner, we've summarized the results. The optimum lambda is 0.31, and we show our 95% confidence limits. Then there's something called the rounded lambda. And what the rounded lambda value is, it's the program searches within the confidence interval and says, is there a whole number or a half within there? And if it is, that becomes the rounded lambda. In this case, it's 0.5, because 0.5 falls within our confidence interval. And that says, well, it's possible then that our transformation is the square root of x. And you have the option of either using the optimum lambda or the rounded lambda in the calculations. Show where that comes from in a minute. The default is the rounded lambda. In addition to this plot, the program also generates output that compares the original data to the transformed data. And it starts with the descriptive statistics. So for the original data, it gives you the count, the mean, standard deviation, etc. And the same thing for the transformed data. Two key parameters here are the Anderson-Darling statistic and the p-value associated with it. So for the data, the Anderson-Darling statistic was 1.036. The key variable is this p-value, though. Low values of p implies that it does not follow a normal distribution. So you can see with our original data, it's 0.01, which is less than 0.05 and very low, so it says the original data doesn't follow a normal distribution. Transformed data, on the other hand, has a p-value of 0.574, which implies it may well follow a normal distribution. You come down below, you can see that we have the two histograms for the original data and the transformed data, and you can easily see that the original data is not normally distributed, while the transformed data appears to be more normally distributed. And then the other plots are the probability plots, where you're plotting the empirical CDF versus the model or the normal distribution CDF. And if it fits a normal distribution, it should lie along a straight line. And you can see the transformed data does a better job of lying along the straight line than the original data does. The other thing that the program will do is print out the results. This is the original data, and then here is the transformed data. And what we were using in this case was the optimal, or excuse me, the rounded lambda, which was 0.5. So the transform data is the square root. So you would simply, to get the transform data, simply take the square root of the original data. And you can see that that gives the transform data. Now you had the option up here to either do the optimum lambda or the rounded lambda. Let me show you where those come up. Back when you originally did the transformation, you had the options down here of Box-Cox options. Select that, and here you can pick either the optimum lambda or the rounded lambda. This is when you have subgroups, you can pick which standard deviation estimation you want to use, either pooled variance, average subgroup, or range, or average subgroup standard deviation. And you also have the options to generate, not to generate these histograms, probability plots, or to show the transformed data. But this is how the program does the Box-Cox transformation. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks for taking the time to watch the video.